I am Orpita Vattacharya, Assistant Professor of English, Swami Vivekananda Institute of Science and Technology, or SVIST. Today my topic is job interviews. Job interviews can be either face-to-face or telephonic, but as an English teacher, communication teacher, I feel that face-to-face job interviews is much more popular and very important for us. So the first point is, for this face-to-face job interviews, is employer's expectations. Your prospective employer might be looking for the qualities in you when you appear for an interview. The first one is disposition. Appearance, clothes, facial expression, gestures, manners, the way you present yourself, the impression you leave on the employer, all these things are components of your personality. Therefore, you must ensure that you present yourself in a manner that leaves a lasting impression. Your next point should be career objective, which is a very important point for the job interview. So the interview panel will be trying to gauge what you want to pursue in your life. You may also be asked where you want to see yourself after 10 years. The panel will try to evaluate your current occupation, stated objectives, consistency, and reasons for change. You should be clear about your career objective and should be able to clearly convey the same to the employer by linking the priorities in your life with your background and aptitude. Third point is subject knowledge. Every employer expects that the prospective employees are well versed with the subjects they had pursued in the past or are. Hence, the employer will be interested in assessing the subjects of your study which are related to your job. So you must brush up the fundamentals of your subject or subjects or any specialization you have pursued. Any shift in terms of area or subject also need to be explained. A good general awareness in the primary requisite of a candidate aspiring for a job today, the point is general knowledge. So the employer tries to assess your curiosity about what's happening all around you, your analytical ability, your mental level, and your potential for coherent perception of multiple happenings. The panel may ask questions ranging from the coup in a country to the announcement of an award to a film. The way you tackle each question is very important. It is necessary to feel confident and develop a positive frame of mind. Next point is communication skill. Communicating effectively is vital for both personal and organizational growth. The employer will try to assess how effective you are in communicating your ideas to him, both verbally and non-verbally, and how intensely you can listen and comprehend. Next point is mental agility. The ability to quickly grasp the question and reply appropriately is a sign of mental alertness. This quality implies quick thinking, presence of mind, and quick response. The interviewer may judge your mental agility by asking an odd question or by making a tricky remark. He could also assess you by the observations you make when he presents you with a practical problem. You can improve this quality by developing the art of concentration, playing carom or chess, solving puzzles, reading witty and humorous plays, and conversing with intelligent people will help in developing this quality. Next point, consistency. A good candidate has a positive and definite and well-developed approach to life. He will seek to his opinion and make judicious decisions. He will not be moved by emotions and external impressions. The interviewer may ask the same questions in a disguised form later in the interview to check your opinion. Never contradict yourself. So your nervous system must have a good amount of strength. So the last point is self-confidence. This is the most essential requirement of a good candidate. Self-confidence means trust in yourself. This generates self-esteem and self-respect. By possessing willpower, socializing, identifying your shortcomings, fighting fear and nervousness, having a positive approach and acting as a leader, you can boost your self-confidence. So now I wish to discuss on the success factors. Taking the right courses, holding good grades, having related work experience are all important selection criteria. But they do not matter much if you do not project the qualities that organization look for. And then the truth is that most interviewers seek individuals who are able to present, who are able to present themselves well in a face-to-face interview. They seek to recommend those who will be a good reflection upon themselves and their selection skill. So most interviewers naturally gravitate to specific critical success factors that have worked for them consistently. So what are the critical success factors? Number one, positive attitude towards work, proficiency in the field of study, communication skill, both oral and written, interpersonal skills, confidence, critical thinking and problem-solving skills, flexibility, self-motivation, leadership, teamwork. So every time try to show your competence in as many of the critical success factors as I have mentioned now as possible, and you will rise above the competition. Make sure of it. So what are the 10 failure factors? They could be turned down for a job. What are they? Like arrogance, apathy, uninhibited nervousness, equivocation, lack of concentration, lack of crispness, lack of social skills, lack of firmness, inadequate quantitative or qualitative skills, unsuitable personality. So be aware of it. Do not encourage these factors within yourself. You know, once Abraham Lincoln said, "Determine that the thing can and shall be done, and then we shall find the way." Now for the interview, particularly for the job interviews, first most important factor is preparation. Successful interviews begin with preparation. Read about your organization before appearing for the interview. Always try to develop a positive attitude. The key to success in an interview is not your experience, your grade, what classes you took, your extracurricular activities or any other basic necessities. Those skills are what got you the interview. The key element can be summed up in one word, that is attitude. If you want to rise above others with better experience, better grades or better skills, you will need to work on developing a highly positive work attitude. The way most employers differentiate at the entry level is by the candidate's attitude towards work. They look for those who have the can-do attitude and are sincerely willing to put forth their very best effort. My next point is go through a mock interview. The mock interview is more than just a chance to work out your interview jitters. It is an opportunity to practice your interviewing technique and answers live. It is also a chance to hear constructive feedback from someone who can guide you towards improving your style and presentation during the real interview. Just one mock interview will bring about a marked improvement in your interview skills. Ideally, I can tell you that the mock session should be videotaped. That way of keeping your video, definitely you can have must two opinions, the mock interviewers and your own opinion, so that you can watch repeatedly. Go through at least one mock interview for maximum effectiveness. Review your answers and then go through a second mock interview. This will give you confidence in your first real interview. Then gather adequate inside information. The very best thing you can do to prepare for an interview with a specific company is to interview someone who is already on the inside. So you can use your network to find out anyone whom you know. So ideally, this would be an individual who went straight out of your institution, into the company. My next point is dress appropriately. So campus fashions and work fashions are two different worlds. So you should be doing the talking, not your clothes. Select conservative, good quality clothes. They should be neat, clean and ironed. Make sure your shoes are conservative, clean and polished. Arrange all your documents systematically in a bag or folder and carry it with you. So be prepared for the questions. Then memorize your resume. Imagine the embarrassment if your interviewer asks you to elaborate on the project which you had done during the course of study. And if you fumble for every item on your resume, try to have a paragraph's worth of information in addition to what is already said. Even better, try to think of a way in which each item illustrates one of your particular strengths or weaknesses. So if you are too nervous to remember everything, it is all right to hold a copy of your resume in your hand to jog your memory. But do not forget to continue making eye contact with your interviewer. Be punctual and at the end, relax. By the time interview day rolls round, you should be set. Get a good night's sleep, eat well, take a relaxing walk beforehand, and remember, it is just one job. If you do not get it, it is not the end of the world. It just means that fate may have even a better opportunity for you waiting around the corner. So, we can think the kind of questions, like you may get experience question. The main purpose of this type of question is to place objective measurements on features of your background, like what is your CGPA, means cumulative grade point average, how long were you at, blah blah blah. Then you may be asked credential questions. This type of question aims at subjectively evaluating features of your background, like what did you learn in your network programming class, what were your responsibilities in that position, blah blah. Then opinion question. This type aims at analyzing subjectively how you would respond in a series of scenarios, like what would you do in this situation, what are your strengths and weakness. And then dumb questions. These questions are asked to find out if you are capable of an original thought. Like, I'm giving you an example. Can you tell this pen to me in 1 minute? What kind of animal would you like to be? And the number 5th, behavioral question. The purpose of this type of question is to anticipate future responses based upon your past behavior. Like, can you give me a specific example of how you did that? What were the steps you followed to accomplish this task? The last one is difficult questions. So good interviewers often ask difficult questions. This is because they have to establish the weakness as well as strength of each candidate. So look at your CV from the interviewer's perspective. List out the gaps, weaknesses, and any problems you can see. So if you were the interviewer, what would you ask? Work out your answer to each question. So in this process, we have to prepare ourselves. We should be very much conscious of the establishing.